Hello friends, this is Rainer again with the Getting Yourself Organized with Org Mode screencast. Today is Thursday, day 4 of the week, that means snippet 4 of episode 3. And today's topic is the function of the properties drawer. Properties drawer is easily explained. It's a drawer that stores task-specific settings and maybe user-defined attributes. A very important thing that was introduced in one of the latest updates to Org Mode is the following. The properties drawer must immediately follow the headline. So you see here some examples. The scheduled entry doesn't harm anything, but if you would have a line in between here, then your properties drawer wouldn't work like expected. And I have to confess, yesterday when we were talking about templates and capturing, I did a small mistake with my book capturing template, because here I have a comment line and the second line directly after the headline, and that rendered my thing for today practically useless until I remembered, oh my god, the property drawer has to go immediately after the headline, so you have to remove that one and put it maybe in there. So now we have a working template, and I already corrected the ones that I captured yesterday. But now let's just have a small quick look at some basic functions of the properties drawer, because I told you there are specific settings or maybe user-defined things. And for one specific setting, let's think we have a goal. We have some repeating tasks like this one. And I show you this one I already repeated a bit. You see there's an entry state done. It was an hour before. And now I repeat the task again. Control C, Control T. I mark it as done. And I get a note, a box that I have to put a note for the state change from next to done. Okay, I can avoid writing a note because I just can press Control C, Control K. Then no note is recorded, but it's still annoying that you always get the dialog, and I mean, it's just a task that is repeating, and the only thing that is important for me is that when it's finished, then that the scheduled date advances to the next occurrence. For example, my weekly review would be such a task, because okay, here I have a logbook for the rescheduling, but just imagine, my weekly review, as you saw yesterday, I have a very long checklist that is captured and then stored in another file, so I really don't have to have a logbook here that says practically I did this task this Friday and last Friday and the Friday before. It's of no use, it's just messing up your org file, and you don't want that. So you see, this is the repeating task A. That's always logging, and that's showing the last repeat was now at 21:14. And okay, but I also have a repeating task B. And now let's do the same with the repeating task B. It's Control C, Control D. We mark it as done. Have a look at this date here. Then you see it advances 1 week, but I don't get a message box that says, okay, please record a note for that status change. And why? The answer is easy. We have a property here that is called logging, and that has the value nil, that means nothing. So here I can really turn off logging, the thing that we practically configured globally for the whole file here in the first line, that we said we want notes every time we enter waiting or every time we enter to do or whatever, then I want to take a note, and here I can just say for this very special task, I don't care about logging, I just want the task to advance to the next occurrence, and I don't have to write it down whatever happened. So that's one system property that is very helpful, because in that case way you can limit the log entries in your file for tasks that are always doing the same. Then we have defined, you remember it, we have defined in our book example some properties. If you look here, we have properties. Let's open the three books. You see now I have moved the properties drawer directly under the headline. And you see we have a pages property and we have a genre property. So now I can show you, if you do agenda views, you can say Control C, A for agenda views. And you see here you can match text properties or to-dos. And let's match example genre gleich equals adventure. So you see the one entry that has genre equals adventure is Robert Louis Stevenson Treasure Island. So I can really select this one task out of my book list. Or let's put another thing here. CA, we match, and now we say we want to have pages more than 200 pages. I want to read a big book. I want to have more than 200 pages, and you see we have Cal Newport with 302 pages and David Allen's book with 352. They are here. So I could also connect that a bit. Let's put it like that. If I want to say I want everything between, let's say, or let's say we want a book less than 352 pages, or less than 350, then we say Control C A, and now match, and we say pages smaller than 350. Now you will get surprised, because we will get a lot of entries. The problem is that in every to-do or whatever entry that you have, and there is no property pages defined, then the value is zero for the pages property. It's undefined, but it matches our, we want all pages less than 350. But of course we can correct that. We redefine the search. It's Control U, Control U and R, and now we say pages greater than zero and pages less than 350. And if I put this, you see I get two books, Cal Newport, Die Burg, because it has 302 pages, and I get Robert Louis Stevenson, Treasure Island, with the 122 pages. So you see, those property matches are very nice when you have a system that you say, I store some properties. I mean, I could even extend my template so that I have a property that says auto and a property that says title. Or in my case, I have experimented with a property that is called goal, and that just defines if a task contributes to a goal that I have or if it's just a task. So I can select practically tasks that contribute to a sort of goal just by property matching. Okay, that's all for today. It's late already and we almost 10 minutes, so I hope you enjoy this screencast. I get a lot of positive comments lately and I get a lot of subscribers, so we will go on. Tomorrow is the latest day for episode 3. We will have a bit more looking at draw, at properties, how, whatever, what else we can do with that. And then for the next week I have to think again what we can do next. I guess somebody asked about timers and time logging, so that would be the next topic in the next week. But so far I hope you learned a lot, and stay tuned. I'll be back as usual tomorrow or maybe on the weekend. I don't know if I have time tomorrow to record a screencast, but at least on the weekend I will do it, and then I will write a blog article about episode 3 with all the text that you need. And yeah, stay tuned. I'll be back and see you tomorrow or whenever. Thank you.